The Belvedere Mansion was built in 1907 by John M. Bayliss and is on the National Register of Historical Places. Mr. Bayliss was born in 1851 in Greene County, Tennessee, but moved to Cassville, Missouri with his family, where he became an adult while working on his parents' farm. He left Cassville to attend college at Hiwassee College of Tennessee and graduated in 1875. He then returned that same year back home to Cassville with 40 cents in his possession. 2 years later, in 1877, he married Frances J. McCary, and shortly afterwards, in 1878, a daughter was born, and they named her Frances. Sadly, Mrs. Bayliss died 1 year after their marriage. Then, another year later, in 1879, Mr. Bayliss married Mary Stubblefield, and they had a total of 7 children from 1880 to 1895. All survived to adulthood except for one daughter named Gracie Ann, who tragically died on March 21, 1881, when she accidentally fell into a fire pit when she was only 8 months old. Her little body was laid to rest at the old Stubblefield Cemetery in Cassville, Missouri, and her inscription reads, Gracie Ann Bayliss, daughter of J.M. and M.M. Bayliss, here our little one lies sleeping in death's long dreamless rest. Eyes though closed on earth are now open in heaven. Mr. Bayliss was a banker and through his own company, circa 1902, built in Claremore a 3-story opera house, the Sequoia Hotel, an athletic building with an indoor swimming pool, and then finally the Belvedere Mansion in 1907 for his family. However, out of all of these buildings, only the Belvedere remains today. Many of the materials used to build the Belvedere Mansion were brought into Claremore from the 1904 St. Louis World Fair. Mr. Bayliss moved his family from Cassville, Missouri to Claremore, Oklahoma to live in the Belvedere. However, sadly, Mr. Bayliss died on June 2, 1907 on the operating table for appendicitis, 6 months before the family was able to move into the mansion. Mrs. Bayless and her children moved into the mansion after his death, where the children grew into adulthood and married, and all seemed well until September 11, 1913, when the family learned about the death of their daughter and sister, Bland, who committed suicide by hanging in her Kansas City home. The Cassville Republican newspaper reported the events of her death, taken from the Kansas City Journal newspaper, and reported, Bland Martin was found dead Thursday evening at her home in Kansas City. Suspended from a curtain rod in a doorway by a piece of clothesline, the body of Mrs. Bland Bayless Martin, wife of William Ferris Martin, an insurance man, was found late yesterday afternoon by her husband when he returned to their home on the second floor of their apartment house at 1606 East 33rd Street. The cause for the suicide is not known. William Ferris Martin, 31 years old, has an office in the Waldheim building. It was his custom to telephone his wife just before he started home for supper. He did this about 5 o'clock yesterday, but the call was unanswered. Thinking his wife had left their flat for a few moments, he went directly home. Entering his apartment and going into the dining room, he was startled to find his wife's body. Immediately, he called for help. The woman was released from the cord, and the frantic husband then endeavored to bring her back to life and would not leave the body until Coroner Karlinski told him there was no hope that Miss Martin could be revived. In 1928, just 15 years after Bland's death, Mrs. Bayless died, and with all the remaining Bayless children now grown and married, the Belvedere Mansion remained empty for a few years until the 1930s, when it was privately purchased and used for apartment units up until the 1960s. By this time, the Belvedere Mansion had become neglected and began showing signs of its age, shown through the rundown conditions of its owners and occupants throughout the years. It was then that the Rogers Historical Society purchased the mansion to restore its beauty and to preserve its historical value and heritage. Today, the Belvedere Mansion is still owned by the Rogers Historical Society, and it has been given back its luxurious stance within the community. So why would the Belvedere Mansion be haunted? Well, many visitors as well as employees who tend to the mansion have witnessed seeing the ghost of Mr. Bayless and also his daughter, Bland. Intrigued not only by the history of the Belvedere Mansion and the Bayless family, but also by the possibility of experiencing paranormal activity, our group set out to investigate. Does the ghost of Mr. Bayless really remain at the mansion? Does he stick around to see how his home is being cared for? Does Bland remain at the mansion, and if so, why? Does she hope she can relive her life differently? These are just some of the questions our group wanted to find out. So join us as we investigate the Belvedere Mansion.
Was having a dinner at the home of his cousins, Mr. A.B. Robinson. In this valuable picture taken in 1927, the photographer caught the famous humorist, and many of his relatives and friends who were among the pioneer families in the community. A 7-minute time was required for this camera to make its way to the picture. Huh. Wow.
Probably Claremore.
Yeah, it is. It's Claremore March. It's got
Pink. March.
It's got Altino on it, Brandon Territory. Claremore, Altino, March. 1926. March 26. 1906.
Yeah, 06. That's 1906. That's what Claremore looked like. Wow. I know why. I'm trying to see.
I'll tell you what I'm getting. I've got a lady who committed suicide by hanging.
Yes, ma'am. That's the daughter.
My neck is just.
Mm-hmm. That's the daughter. That's who you're picking up on. See, I can't count on this one because I already know the history.
Throat was hurting. That's right here.
His daughter did commit suicide. Mr. Bayless' daughter did commit suicide. I believe her name was Bland.
Yeah,
according
I've got it written down in my notebook.
Yeah.
He was in the cemetery.
Right, according to the records, she was in her early 20s, I think.
Well, it's like really very, very, she's depressed.
Very depressed, and I know why.
I know why.
I picked up on the last time that I was here.
Every time we moved, there was a place that just hurts.
Yep. That was her. You're picking up on Bland. And there are pictures of her downstairs as well. So I'll show you a picture of her. But I believe, do you remember, I believe she was in her early 20s, wasn't she?
Yeah, and there was also, they think there was twins, too. They're not sure, but they mentioned two twins. But one child was more, they died. There's mentioned now in the cemetery records. Two more children, and they think that there wasn't a name for twin. They think it's twin B, but it didn't say anything about twin A.
Very good, Anita.
There's also the moon.
Yes, there is. Yes, there is. From the records, I won't go into detail. I won't go into detail, but there is a man. Yes.
His name John.
John
and
Bayless.
And by the name of Isaac.
Yes. John Bayless is the one who built the house. He died in this house. And the rumor is for everybody that there is a man and there is a woman that are seen here. And they are the ones that haunt the Belvedere Mansion. And many believe that it is John Bayless as the man, and then his daughter, Glenn. And many believe that it is John Bayless as the man, and then his daughter, Glenn.
Flipping the marbles.
Because that's what I picked up on, and it's on video too. It was my impression there in this room here. where I saw the children, and there was three of them sitting on the floor. There were two girls and a boy. And I see them actually playing.
She has an attitude, right?
The older one?
Like, she's spicy.
Yeah. But like I said, I picked up on them the first time I was here in that room, and I saw them flipping the marbles on the floor.
See, my neck is burning, literally burning.
That's her. I picked up on that, too.
Burning all through here and back from Rick.
Thank you, because you just validated that thing for me.
I love it.
It's so great. See, I already knew coming in here since I've been here before, but I wanted to see what you guys thought of it.
What did she change? Because I get that she's very, very depressed.
Yes, she's very depressed.
What is the problem? Because I see baby, loss of baby.
And there's a relationship is what I picked up on.
Was he was really, really weird.
Yeah.
Okay, because that's what I said.
And where I encountered her was actually on the second floor. I won't tell you where, but I actually saved her looking out the window, staring out, like waiting for him.
Well, I was pulled to this, as soon as she came to steps, that room. That's an office.
Over here? Mm-hmm. Or the one up here?
No, the one, as soon as she walked up the second steps, that room over there.
The small room?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That goes into another room or something. That's where I kind of got it. Yeah.
You validated everything that I got before. So.
It helped. I mean, it feels like someone's literally turning my neck.
Just because she
just turning, it hurts.
And like I said before, the records and stuff on it too. When you all the records, you see this. There was, she committed suicide.
And now, did John's wife die also?
I don't think there's any records that she died in the house.
Because I remember being, because I picked up on his wife. Wife and children. Three sons worked at the bank. One was a postmaster. And I've got it right now in a year for the wine.
Those are your records that she got.
What's 19? I get like
19. That's when the house was built, I believe.
This house was built. I think
it's 1906.
I can't remember. There's stuff in this kid's mind.
Well, and there's, you notice too, there's and like I said, she could do some more full research on it and pull all the historical records.
Was he a banker himself?
Yes. He was into banking. He was into a lot of stuff.
Real estate.
He had real estate. He had a lot of money.
He was into government.
Yeah, they just shared with us that he died shortly after the race.
What happened?
So, cool. I had a neat little experience out here just a second ago. I was actually standing over here and I was filming upstairs. And as I was filming, I could kind of like see out of my peripheral vision to my right, like a shadow, and it was over here, and I'm looking this way, and I thought it was one of the group members, and so as soon as I got through panning down the camera, I looked over, and I thought one of the group members was there, and I looked back, and I said, hello, and there was nobody there, and I went in, and all the group members were in there in the front living room, and I asked if anybody was right over here just a second ago, and they said no. But I actually saw like a shadow figure standing right beside me, kind of like looking at what I was doing here. So that was kind of neat.
What's the deal with St. Louis?
It's from there.
Yeah, something to do with this house in St. Louis.
There was furnishings and
woodwork
and stuff that was imported.
Walking like this,
yeah.
You know how you kind of see some out the corner of your eye.
Uh huh.
Go
I saw some kind of into that research room.
Really?
And you walk in there, you just kind of get this eerie feeling.
Visited this, I think it was back in 2001 or so. This is the room actually where I had seen the three children playing in the middle of the floor. There was two girls and a boy. Where I had seen them at was kind of right off in here, and there was the two girls here, and there was the boys, and the one boy, and they were flipping the marbles across the floor. And I actually seen them flip the marbles this way, back toward the little turret there. So then when Anita had come in here, she had never been here before, and she actually said that she had picked up on three children playing with marbles as well. So that was kind of cool for both of us to pick up on it. But this is the initial room that I seen it in. What's that, Chris? Oh yeah, I seen that.
A whole little city room off of each room.
I know, isn't that cool how that is?
Yeah.
In the little turrets. I think there's a little tea set or something set up there. It's kind of cool how they got it set up. That's where you saw the kids. Was that, did you see them looking down, you said, over the... The banister?
No, they're on the floor, like two girls and a boy. There's an older girl, a smaller girl, and then a boy that's probably in between them.
Right close by. See the room that I first picked up on them at? What was that one right over there? Have you been in that room yet? Do you know who the kids are, if they're related to the Bayless family? You pick up on that? Huh?
Just passed from the room where we was at into this room.
So from the back.
Yeah, it looks like it has a black, big black dress on. Feel that? Like something going between us?
No.
Oh my gosh.
I felt cold.
Oh my god. Feel my heart. That just scared the holy crap out of me.
Get that on film.
You didn't feel that?
I'm filming.
It's just like something just passed between us. Just, I mean.
Who's got a temp gauge?
Me.
Your heart's still pounding?
Yeah, my heart's pounding. Yeah. Okay, I got spooked.
And we didn't catch it on film.
I've done one before, so.
That back, back light on this one, it works with the laser. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that's
what
happened.
Nice.
Right, it's 76 degrees in here.
Did you ever pick up on a name Gracie? Like Gracie Lynn?
You know, it's been so long, I can't remember if I picked
Chris
that up.
That's outside.
Yeah. That's outside. That's a kid's own.
Okay.
That's your own tennis court.
That it went from here to there. And you know what I'm thinking?
What?
Is that the hole that leads up the stairs?
Can yeah.
They can come. That's one.
Yeah, actually it is.
So she just came past us.
Woo! That's scary to think of, huh? So probably what she did is she went from that room into that room and came around and up the stairs.
Was that you? Could you please? Can you do it again? I'm sorry, you sort of startled me.
Like if I was to do that. You see how that reflected when I went by?
Yeah.
Like that? Who's blocking the light now?
Me?
The light? You are? Okay. I don't think it'd be from.
Could it be from a car reflection? Can I take a window on that? On that picture? What's that knocking on?
I don't know, but I've seen it pass by right here.
I heard the knocking, right? It wasn't me.
I just turned the camera on.
Was it the floor?
No, it sounded like a knock.
It was
like
a knock.
Like two knocks.
Like two knocks.
It was over here by Chris, though.
Let's be quiet for a second. See.
Was it the banister?
Mm-hmm.
What was that?
I don't know.
That was downstairs.
Did you hear that in here?
I heard.
Is somebody else here?
I heard a woman say, mm-hmm. Did you not hear that in here?
Yeah.
I heard a woman's voice.
Anybody say, mm-hmm?
Uh-uh. We're looking at you guys. But me and her both in a shower while I'm in here.
Well, I heard, it sounded like just right inside the door here. I heard it. That's what it sounded to me. It sounded like it was right inside this door and it sounded very plainly. Really? You guys saw a shadow walking out? Cool. So that'd be kind of neat if they saw the shadow walking out of this room and right about close to that same time I hear a woman 3 feet from you maybe saying, mm-hmm.
Why did you hang yourself?
It's bland is what it is.
Give us a clue why. Was your life so bad?
Who is standing right there?
Huh?
I think the reports, when they report hearing the woman's dress, like the rustle of the dress going up the stairs, honestly think that's her.
Taking a picture of her by step, because there was just a shadow that was all around her in the back. Whoever just took a picture just flashed.
Did you hear him walking out there? Come on in, Bland. Come talk with us. That's me. Was that you?
That was me. That was me.
Oh, okay.
How old were you when you took your life?
Not many. 22 or 23. I'm not sure. Dee, do you know about that?
Stay here? Or is this where you feel comfortable? Because this was your home.
Y'all still hearing stuff out there in the hall? Oh, that was me.
What'd you do?
I just bumped to the side of the door.
Did you guys just clear your throat and help?
Yeah, one of them did in here.
Okay.
That was them in the background saying thank you. Do you hear that in there, Anita?
Yeah. Did you hear a woman's voice?
Huh?
Did you hear a woman's voice?
Mm-hmm. And I heard a thud thud. Like, ch ch. Did you hear that? Is anybody whispering out there? I'm hearing a woman whisper. Did you hear her right then? It sounded like it was right in my right ear, though.
Who's walking real fast?
Who's walking out there? Hold still for just a sec, please, hon. Did you not hear the whispering?
Yeah, but I wonder if it's from outside.
It sounded like it was right in my right ear. Like someone was leaning over my shoulder. That was me. Floor puffing.
Okay. Sorry, that was me. Did you hear something?
I had the chair squeaking in my ear.
No, I keep hearing like... almost like a real delicate voice.
Yes. Are you hearing it loud audible? I've heard it loud audible and I've heard it whispering.
Yeah, it's like almost like wanting to tell us something. Try and talk to us, like wanting
to convey a message.
Not really to convey a message, but almost like a plea of wanting to get a point across. That's what I get.
I think there's a lot of remorse and guilt, and maybe that's something that's wanting to come out. As of to why things have happened the way they did. Yeah.
Did you just hear it?
No, that's Stephanie saying Chris.
No, did you just hear that?
No,
whenever you said that, there's a yes.
I didn't hear it, no.
Yeah, it's... You guys didn't say yes, did you?
Chris just did.
Just now, but that wasn't when you said it was. Okay, everybody be real quiet for just a second. Land, are you wanting to get a message across to let us know that you are guilty about, or you feel guilty about what you did, and you're remorseful, and... Maybe you want us to let you know that it's something maybe you didn't mean to do, maybe you did, but you really didn't want to do it, or you felt bad about it afterwards.
Who's upstairs?
Nobody.
Hear that walking on the side?
Mm-mm, I didn't hear it.
Do what?
Stephanie heard it upstairs, she said. I heard it there.
Somebody's walking up there.
No, it's this right up above us.
Yeah, this is right up above me.
Saw that curtain moving?
Yeah. You guys were seeing the curtain move? Where'd you see the curtain move at?
Not straight from me. Yeah, by the dollhouse.
Which way did you see? I mean, did you see it open or did you see it like blow?
I just seen it move just in.
It's like looking.
Well, this will sound crazy, like my eyes are playing tricks on me, but when I first thought I saw it move, it looked like there was a... I didn't see a face, but it looked like somebody had their head in the curtain pushing it out. Yeah. Is what I saw first.
Looked like somebody was looking
right there in
the
middle.
Curtain.
Christopher, how much sci-fi channel have you been watching lately?
Well, that's all I watch.
I'm just kidding.
You know what I'm saying? I didn't see a face. It just, it looked like...
Looked like the imprint of it, right?
I saw the curtain.
You saw the curtain move, Steph?
Yes. And I knew that's what he went to go look at.
He just did it.
Yeah.
Darn it, I just turned the camera off on it every time.
It's moving now. Yes.
Let me get my do with the camera. Chris, you're blocking the view. Is it moving from the left to the right or from the right to the left? My camera's having a hard time focusing on it. There we go.
That's me. I don't want to get in the way.
Are you guys seeing the edge of it move or are you seeing...
I'm just seeing the middle of it.
Well, if it did, I should have it on film.
It's very...
If
you're not looking at it, you won't see it.
Rhonda, where are you at?
He's sitting down
on
his
couch. Chris said it looked like a face.
Yeah.
Coming out of him.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Oh, my God.
Do you see what I'm talking about? It wasn't like that earlier.
No, it wasn't like that when we were in here earlier.
See what I mean?
Oh, where it's bulging out?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what first caught my eye.
Let me get from a side view. I'm talking about that part right there, bulging out.
Let me take a shot. I mean, it's awesome.
Not that I don't believe you, but... I'd like to see it for myself.
Let's stand here for a minute.
I'd like to see it for myself.
Let's stand here for a minute.
Not that I don't believe you, but... I'd like to see it for myself.
Let's stand here for a minute.
see if it moves. Blend, is that you moving the curtain?
Excuse me, that's my stomach. Did one of you guys just hum?
I did hear that. They're like, hmm.
I heard it too.
I heard it too.
It wasn't none of you guys out there?
No.
Cool beans.
That was you. Could you say it again, please? We're trying to understand why you did what you did. Can you give us a sign of some sort?
Yep, I was just fixing to say conversation. You took the word out of my mouth.
Like a male and a female.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I'm only catching like bits and pieces of like higher pitched. You can't. It's like muffled. I can't understand
this
all of what's being said.
Hers is like you can hear.
Her voice stronger.
Did you get into an argument with your husband before you took your life?
Do you hear that? Do I hear like voice?
Yes.
Sounds like it's coming out there somewhere. I'm gonna move because I'm really feeling uncomfortable over there.
Did you hear that?
Right there? It sounded like it was right over here on the floor.
Yeah, that's what I said, that's in here.
It's kind of funny because I just got through saying I feel real uncomfortable over there. It sounded like a, I don't know, like you flick your finger down on the floor. I guess that's a good way to describe it.
Or dropping marbles.
Mm-hmm. Not the same as when you're stepping on the ground, like, you know.
Listen.
That knock? Yes.
I keep hearing, like, I'm Gracie Ann, I'm Gracie Ann.
You hear any laughter, giggle?
Yeah, like a child. It's mm-hmm. Like I'm Gracie Ann. Hear it?
Okay, you guys still hear him shuffling upstairs? Very funny that you should say that. Would you like me to tell you why? Because that sound has been reported up in the ballroom by one of our investigators the last time around, and by some other stories that I've heard here.
Really?
And in addition to that, remember I told you the rustling of the dress going up the stairs?
Mm-hmm.
And that's been heard too.
Well, that's what it sounds like almost that old type of material.
Mm-hmm.
And you know how you're walking and how a lady would walk gracefully and shh, that's how it sounds like it's from like shh, shh.
Mm-hmm. Quit squeaking floor. That's me, I'm sorry.
There ain't nobody up there, right?
No.
I thought I saw a shadow up there.
Well, let's head upstairs then.
Because I can see the...
You think it's the male up there now, or is it still the female?
Well, just, I can see the light between the boards on that railing, you know, for the hole.
Mm-hmm.
And I've seen where the light spots get dark just for a second.
Wish I could see that more at the night shot. It's not as good as our eyes, I guess.
She feels almost ashamed. Well, she does feel ashamed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and kind of sorrowful that it happened or whatever.
Like guilty.
Mm-hmm. That's what I picked up on, too. The last time I was here, too, when I picked up on it, I kind of got a mixed balance of, like, it was something she wanted to do and then something that she didn't want to do. You know what I mean? It was a lot of mixed emotions.
I can't take any pictures, Chris.
Well, we can go downstairs. Do you just have regular double A's?
I was looking up in the windows, and so we walked around the side of the house and cut down. There's like a flower bed or something over there. You have to step down and come around. And whenever we came to the side, I seen Chris and Steph standing looking at something. I don't want you guys were looking at something right here in the kitchen.
Oh yeah, the tea. There's little tea
packets.
Things. Yeah.
And I said we was gonna peck on the window at them, and all of a sudden there's a light on up in those two windows right up above the head on like on the left hand side. And it went out. It just went out. So I thought, well, maybe you guys are starting with those. Because then whenever I seen them guys go that way, right after it went out. So we walked around here, and I seen all four, you and Roger and Dee and Bree sitting on the porch.
Mm-hmm.
So it could be you guys. You guys are here. They just went that way, and we're outside. So
we didn't miss anything.
And I know that we had all the lights out when we came outside the building for break.
Yeah.
We had every
single light. It was a light.
Except for the kitchen. But it was a light on the second story. But when we were sitting out here too, I noticed that, and I know you heard it, Roger, didn't you?
Yeah.
And Bree, you heard it.
Yeah.
Dee, you heard it, right? And I know I heard it. I was sitting there, Roger was sitting over there, Bree was here, and Dee was there, and it sounded like someone was over there rustling in the bushes, and I knew you and Chicky were out on the grounds, and I thought it was you, and so I said, what are you guys doing, looking for Bigfoot out there,
that's
you
what
know?
She, yeah, she
yeah.
That's what she
and
said.
I didn't hear a response or anything. But then all of a sudden, not too long after that, you come running up around the corner saying, Christy, Christy, and then you were telling me about that.
Yeah, because we just walked around. We didn't stop. Went down.
Well, this sounded like someone, and it probably did it for about a good, 20 seconds or so?
Yeah, it was
It was pretty long, like shh, yeah. Shh, like someone messing with the bushes.
Because we all looked
maybe
there.
Maybe they're upset because we're not up there talking to them no more.
What? I know, that's the sidewalk that goes all the way around you. It's not really a sidewalk, I don't think. I think it's grass. Is there a sidewalk that goes around there, Roger, that you're seeing?
It looks like something going off the side right
off
there.
Off the porch right there.
The porch sidewalk.
Yeah,
the porch. Yeah. But there's the red bud tree, and then there's also the bushes that's right over here. And like I said, it sounded like the bushes and
no,
sitting right here right behind
me. I was trying to scare you, I'd have ran up that step probably.
Well, I was expecting you to do something anyway, outside on break.
Because I was looking at the windows to see why some are square and then they have round. Have you noticed that?
Yeah.
It's like square opposite. Yeah. Rounds.
That's what I was looking at whenever I went around. But that's odd because, I mean, it's almost like someone just shut the light off.
Well, what we'll do is we'll go around there in a second and I'll let you guys point out the window.
It's right and above the stair is right above there.
Yeah, that's right.
We're next, right on. And we were looking up at them. And it just goes, we're like, oh wow.
And I thought you guys started without us.
That's
why we were around here.
And
because whenever
were
the
right
light went
the
off,
kitchen. They weren't upstairs.
Well, whenever the light went off, they went that way. So I thought you guys had already started without us. That's why I was stunned whenever I came around the corner and I seen these two and you guys sitting. I'm like,
wait a minute.
Yeah. You know, they're sitting on the porch and those two just went that way and we're the only two left and we're out here. But yeah, it went off.
Oh. What do you guys think so far tonight, too, as far as, what do you guys think about the activity so far that we've witnessed?
It's been interesting.
It has
very,
been pretty interesting.
Very interesting. My thing is, though, is it a residual type of haunting, though?
That's what I was wondering. Residual? Or is it
well, haunted? One way that we'll find out is we have audio and we have video. And
because I get nothing on the first floor.
Well, isn't residual the same thing?
It replaced, yes.
Over and
right.
Over.
But
like a video.
Like a video.
Camera. Like a video.
But if you've got children messing with my shirt, but you still hear the noises going up downstairs, like everybody's always said before, they hear the rustling and stuff.
Well, besides that, we saw the shadows and stuff.
The shadows playing with the curtains.
One way that you'll find out, one of the ways that you will be able to tell the difference between a residual haunting and an intelligent haunting is your intelligent hauntings, you actually have some sort of, interaction on your audio. Like if they jump in on your conversation or if, you have some sort of, communication or if you ask them to knock, if they go ahead and knock. Residual is just going to be...
Well, that's why I said residual, because up above us,
it could be.
It's almost like dancing. The
now,
shuffle
that could,
dancing.
That could be. Now, I know from what we picked up on Bland, though, tonight, and then also maybe from the male, I feel Bland more stronger tonight than I even do the male, supposedly Mr. Bayless or whatever. But, like I said, when we review over our evidence, we're going to know a difference. Residual is not going to communicate with us whatsoever. As far as, making sounds or jumping in on our audio recordings or so forth. So.
I want to go up and see what that is, if that's the hallway or if that's a room.
It's a bedroom. I know exactly which bedroom that is. It's the one that's got the buggy in it, I'm pretty sure.
That's the one where...
Where the curtain is?
Do you remember when you walk in?
That's the one with the black dress, isn't it?
No. You walk. It's got the bodice, bare bodice.
Okay.
Remember, there's no clothing or anything on it. And there's the black baby buggy with the baby in it. And then there's windows. Oh. There's windows on this side, and then there's windows over here and over here going around.
What's the set of two?
I think it's that one. I may be wrong.
I think it's the bathroom because I remember when I was in the bathroom, I could see Steph out there taking pictures. So I was trying to
see what it is.
Well, let's go see.
Me too.
Where is it? I got my hat on. Like I said, when we review over our evidence, we're going to know a difference. Residual is not going to communicate with us whatsoever.
Yeah.
As far as, making sounds or jumping in on our audio recordings or so forth. So...
I want to go up and see what that is, if that's the hallway
or Mr. Bayless or whatever. But, like I said, when we review over our evidence, we're going to know a difference. Residual is not going to communicate with us whatsoever.
Yeah.
As far as, making sounds or jumping in on our audio recordings or so forth. So.
I want to go up and see what that is, if that's the hallway or...
Well, let's go up there and determine which room it is. And then we'll go outside and we'll film it for camera to show what happened there. Okay, maybe we'll put this back on.
Let's see if I got a picture of the super.
the lights were off, guys. We didn't leave any. The only light we had on
that's
the
switch. That's what Mom, that's what she thought.
And that's why I got sort of thrown
off. Okay, so it's a different room then. Are you going back downstairs?
Yeah.
Okay, well, hang on. I need to hang on. I'll go down there with the camera. Can two people or someone stay up here and flip the light? Doesn't matter. Two people outside and see if that's the same one.
It's gotta be. It is.
Yeah, I noticed that one. It was a double window.
The only light that was on was this kitchen light when we were taking a break. Or
no, it's a room.
Okay.
See, we've been sitting there about 10 minutes.
Because we were trying to find a stick to scare him with.
Because I was going to knock on the window.
Yeah. Hang on, I'm going to get my...
That's Roger.
He's up there with them still, I think.
We're sitting right here.
Okay. It's on now.
That's it.
That's the room.
That's so, the room. When's it? That's the room.
Turn it back on.
Back on.
That's exactly what it did.
It went off.
Whenever it came around the corner, I seen it was on, but I thought it might have been somebody up there putting something.
Is that the room that we were sitting in, y'all were sitting in before?
No.
No.
No, that's on the other side.
Here, right here is where we stopped at, and Stephanie and Chris were standing right through those windows, and I was going to look for something, because I was going to tap on the window at it, and that light just went off. And then Steph and Chris walked that way, and I thought, well, come on, Chicky.
Chicky, where were you standing?
Right next to me.
I was right here, because I was looking for a stick. And we were standing here, and then we noticed it was on, and then we were standing looking at Chris, and then it goes off, and Mom's like, without us?
Like I said, that light shouldn't have been on to begin with, because we left all the lights off.
We didn't even go in that room
for
no.
See, that's what startled me, because I thought whenever it went off, Chris and Steph went that way, so I thought you guys was already up there starting without us. But that's the room that the light went off. I mean,
no, because me and Steph and Chicky was up there getting the readings and stuff, but we had the flashlight.
Yeah, like I said, we had the lights all the way off.
Yeah. No, that's the lights that was on.
Except for the kitchen.
No, it was those double windows that was on, and it looked like someone just shut the light off.
That's kill the light, guys. Yeah. Well, y'all have it happen.
Right that corner. It sounds like somebody walking. You can hear the floor creaking.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Cool. You sure it wasn't us downstairs?
No, it's up here. It's almost like new office.
And it's over here, this corner? Funny that you should mention that. You know why? Because there's been reports of people being seen in that corner. There's no light. I said, this house, it gets really, really, really dark when there's no light.
Well, I kept seeing a mist. And every time I take a picture, it was like a mist.
Where were you seeing it? Up here?
Yeah, I kept seeing it. All of us seen it. It was like a white glowing mist. Almost like someone that was smoking.
Well, we know none of us are smoking.
Can you give us a sign of your record for this?
What happened when you guys were going to sit down, Steph?
Well, we were all four corners. Sitting over there, and Chris was in his little corner, and Chicky were on each end of this one. And we heard, like, it sounded like something dropped, like a ray dropped, something like that. Not like a scoop, but like something dropped.
Did it sound like it shuffled across the floor?
Mm-hmm. That's almost what it sounded like.
It did?
Like.
Yeah, that's what it sounded like.
More of not a shuffle, more of a kind of a pick up type. Like that.
It was loud.
Like that.
Really?
Like that.
Yeah. Did you guys, did y'all see the stationary array move, or did you guys?
We weren't watching it.
We were watching. Chris said he could see it, and he didn't see it move, but.
When I heard it move, I thought Steph dropped something.
I didn't drop anything.
And nobody dropped anything?
Mm-hmm.
No?
And then in between me and Steph, it sounded like a cat. Like a noise, like a cat noise being made in between us. Mm-hmm. I don't know what it was.
Cool.
Hearing what you heard.
Yeah.
What did Chris hear?
Ask him.
He's right behind you.
Okay, Chris, what did you hear?
I thought I heard, I don't want to be dead.
I don't want to be dead? Did you think you heard it audibly?
Yeah.
Does it sound like female or male?
Female.
It was a female. I heard, but I just heard, I don't want, and I didn't hear the rest of part of it, the back part of it, but over around him, there were shadows all around where he was sitting.
Well, Chris, where were you sitting at, and where did you hear that?
Back bench over there.
The one right up over there?
Yeah.
Okay, and did you hear it, like, in your right ear, your left ear?
Like, it was all around me. Hmm. I couldn't tell you exactly where, it just... And after I heard it, it kept just running through my mind over and over and over again. That's when I asked Anita, I said, if she had heard anything. And she said she heard the I don't part.
But I didn't hear the rest.
Did you have an audio recorder on you?
No.
Darn it.
Oh, you're probably going to hear that shuffle because it was
loud. It was loud.
Well, Chris, that's bright. It was real loud. Because if that glass wasn't there, I would have said it was you guys downstairs. But that glass is there. Remember me shining the light on you and you waved at me?
Yeah.
That's why I did that, because I went over there and looked. Because it was loud. It was extremely loud.
I was wondering what you guys were doing.
That's what I was doing, to see if you guys were moving, if you guys were seeing.
The beans.
We're up there.
Like,
right
there.
So you guys about ready to wrap up then? Get with everybody here on the floor.
Okay, now this is hilarious.
What?
Upstairs, my battery was completely dead, and I just turned it on.
Well, you got battery?
Yeah, I got brand new. It's all cool.
So, what do you guys think? Are y'all ready to wrap it up? Call it a night?
Yeah.
I think we
got
anybody have light they
can flash? I got light. The camcorder. All right. Yeah. And an exciting night at the Belvedere Mansion. All right, y'all think it's been a good night?
Oh yeah,
yes, definitely.
It has been a good night.
You think we got some evidence?
I hope we got some evidence. We've heard enough.
Yeah, had a lot of interesting things happen, from shadows to sounds to voices. So we'll see what we get recorded.
Sure.
Yeah, your shirt getting tugged. All right, wrapping up on Belvedere, going home. We'll see how it all turns out when we do our evidence.
Okay, I'm stopping recording.
Yeah, ain't you?
And many believe that it is John Bayless as the man, and then his daughter, Blanche. And I don't want to drive with it like that. Oh, my heel. I'd like to see it for myself. Okay, I'm stopping recording.
Yeah, I am too.
Like I said, when we review over our evidence, we're going to know a difference. Residual's not going to communicate with us whatsoever.
Yeah.
As far as, you know, making sounds or jumping in on our audio recordings or so forth. So.
I want to go up and see what that is. If that's the hallway.